Okay, we're gathered here today on the event of the Monaghan reunion, September the 7th, 2007. We're part of the Greenville Textile Heritage Society, and this is our oral history project that we're working on. It's a project where we're getting memories and stories from our people, from our mill villages that we can place in our archives and have them there for centuries should the Lord tarry. And our kids, our grandkids, and great-grandkids can go into our archives and find out some of the memories of their parents and grandparents. And we have a distinguished panel with us here today from Monaghan. We have Gladys Thackston, Jack Pittman, and Mattie Harvell, all who have deep roots in the Monaghan mill village. And they're going to share with us today some of their memories. And again, this is the day of the Monaghan reunion, 2007. Monaghan has been around since the year 1900. The Parker cousins, Lewis Parker and Thomas Parker, were the chief architects of this mill village. And certainly there are a lot of people who played a part in making Monaghan a great mill village. Dr. L.P. Hollis had his footprints that he left on the mill village as he moved on to into the Parker School District and built it, and other things that he helped build around the greater Greenville area. And we just want our panel today to share with us some of their memories. We'll first start with Gladys and ask her to just describe the circumstances surrounding her family coming to Monaghan and where she lived, and a little bit about the early history of her family and where they lived on the mill village. And then we'll let Jack share that same set of circumstances, and then also Mattie. And then we'll move on to another topic and some more subjects. So we're excited about what they're sharing with us today, and also about our reunion tonight. We're expecting about 300 people to gather here at the Monaghan Family Life Center and just share memories and good times and renew old acquaintances. So we're excited about this event and just want to share a little bit with the public. So we'll move right along and let Gladys just share her thoughts about her parents coming to Monaghan and the circumstances and a little bit about her history of her family.
I love Monaghan. I've always lived at Monaghan. When I was 2 weeks old, my mother and daddy carried me up on Post Street to our Baptist church up there. I lived on Frost Street, and Dr. Hollis lived right behind us. We had some wonderful times at Monaghan. The things I liked most about it was our Y. You could do just about anything there. We had skating, we had basketball, we had baseball, we had tennis, and we had a Dr. White, lots of you know him. He would come in the afternoons and come in that side door, and that's where the patients would come to see him. We had movies on Friday night, and we had just about anything anybody could want. And we had good baseball teams and basketball teams. They went on to the tournaments, and I'm very proud to say that I was raised at Monaghan.
Can you tell how your family got to Monaghan? What, were they on the farm before that, or do you know how your mother and dad arrived, or what year they arrived on the village?
No, I can't tell you when. But my daddy lived out at Taylor's, out at Cheek Springs, you know, where the old lake was. And my mother, her daddy was the fire chief down on Macby Avenue, and they lived upstairs over that. Okay. And then when they met, and then they came to Monaghan.
Okay, thank you. Jack.
Thank you for having the privilege to tell you what I know about Monaghan. I have what my father, Lee Pittman, has told me. My father was building houses for Fisk Carter down at Piedmont, South Carolina, And they moved to Monaghan to finish up the Mill Village, which started back on YMCA Street and went up to
Lindsay
Street. And he come here in between 1918 and 1919 to Monaghan Mill. And he was building these houses, and Mr. Marchant and Mr. Cottingham asked my grandfather, Lee Allison, could they hire one of their carpenters away from Fitz Carter? And he said, yes, my son-in-law is young and all, and I'd like for him to have that job. My father was over the carpenters there at Monaghan, which they had about 18 at that time. And he was over the carpenters at Victor Mill and over the carpenters at Wall Holler, the Kenneth plant. And they finished up these houses, and he went in the mill. And when if you worked at Monaghan, you could live in the houses. And the people paid 25 cents a room for their rent a month. And so they furnished lights and water. And if you'll look at the first picture as you go around to your left, you'll see how they made the power here at Monaghan for the old mill houses. They had over 100 ropes in there that pull that wheel. And they would draw the water from the lakes out there. And sometime back when we were little, our lights would flash or something. When they'd flash like that, Daddy said one of the ropes had broken. And so they would replace it. So that is the memory I have of my folks coming to Monaghan Mill. And I was born and raised on 13 Beatty Street, Monaghan.
I'm Mattie Mullinax Harvell. My daddy was Charlie H. Mullinax. And he and his family were all reared up around Gap Creek and Falls, River Falls, and Cherokee. And they heard that they were hiring some people down at Pelzer. So they left all that land, all of that property and everything, and come down to Pelzer. And it wasn't long till my granddaddy, James Swalford Mullinax, became the superintendent of Pelzer Mill. And how Daddy got to Monaghan, I really don't know. They hired him anyway, and he was a section man in the card room. And he and Joe Moody. And when we first moved here, we moved on McDonald Street. That's where Fanny Mullinax Ballinger was born. And she was born in 1918. So I know that we were here before then. So I've narrowed it down to around, and he was in service, and I'll narrow it down to about 19 and 15 that we moved here. And then on Serene Street, over near the end toward Parker Road at Merritt's Grocery Store, my younger sister, Lucille, and I were born there in that corner house. And we lived there for a while until we moved to Norwood. And I'm like Gladys, I remember the church on Post Street. Every one of us girls were dedicated there at that church. And I remember that when it burned and how we ran down Thomas Street to see it, and Albert Jolly stopped us young girls from going down there because he said it was too hot. And he wouldn't let us go any further than down there where the parsonage was on YMCA Street. So I can remember all of that. And so when we came, after they built those new houses on from YMCA Street up, the ones that were section men got the 5-room bungalows, and Dad got 20, and Mr. and Miss Strange got 19. So I know a lot about Gladys, and then Jack Earl being on the next street, Beatty. We all grew up together there. In fact, Gladys and I started school at the same time. And there was a lot that was being done at the school. We'll tell that later. But anyway, the circumstances of us coming there was that they were beginning to hire people at Monaghan. And I have learned, I've lived at Monaghan all my life, and most of the time they're at 20 Speed Street, and that's still my address. And I've always been proud of Monaghan. I was thankful for the accomplishments that had been made, and we have beautiful neighbors around us. And we'll talk a little bit later on the other things, if it's, that's the way you want it to go.
Uh-huh. Thank you, and I appreciate all that input. And certainly we have some long-term Monaghanites here with us today that knows Monaghan in and out. And I could say that I'm also lived 20 years in the same house on Speed Street, number 13 Speed Street. So I know a little bit about Monaghan myself. And my mother lived there from 1940, and we still own the house today. It's still there. She's not able to live there anymore, but we still own the house there at 13 Speed Street. And there's been a lot of changes over the years, but I'm too proud of Monaghan and love Monaghan, love the Monaghan people. And it's just exciting for me to be a part of this reunion today, a part of this panel. And we'll just move right along. And the second thing I wanted to talk, Gladys mentioned a little bit about this earlier, about the different activities. But if you would go through and each one share a little bit about some of the activities that you participated in. The certainly Monaghan was instrumental in a lot of the new programs that were instituted by the Parkers and Dr. Hollis, and Monaghan led the way in a lot of areas, and we're proud of what was accomplished. And but if you would just share a little bit about your perhaps your involvement in your community events, the school, church, the mill, ladies' club, or anything that you've got memories of that you participated in back in those days, and even in the younger, your younger years. So Gladys, if you would just start.
I love the Y. I like to skate. We've skated every Friday night, and then we had the movies there. And we had a tennis court. We played tennis there. And it was good to watch the, we had good ball teams. And those, you'll see pictures of those guys that was on those ball teams. We had girl basketball teams. And it was just a wonder. We had a golf course. It was in the cow pasture. And Mr. What's his name?
Mr. Shelton
was the one that took care of the golf course, and he would be out there every morning taking care of the greens, and there was lots of people. I imagine that's where they learned to play golf.
Me and my brother, we were into a lot of things as young boys, and we played ball down at Monaghan, and as I told you, my father was head carpenter there, and on Halloween night we would go up on Speed Street and we would turn out turn over the outhouses. And my poor old daddy and all of his carpenters, we wouldn't do that on Beatty. We'd do it on Speed and other and YMCA Street. And one night me and Ken and Pete Ab Welcher, he died when he was a young boy. We went down Speed Street, turning them over, and lo and behold, when we got to Ms. Merritt's house, we turned it over and we didn't know she was in there. And she started hollering, we run as fast as we could run to get out of there. Then we had a man that used to come around with a honey wagon there at Monaghan. His name was Elry. And all of y'all remember Elry and the honey wagon. And he would go around up and down the back alleys. We had a back alley that even a car could run in, but he'd bring that old mule and his wagon, them three barrels up through there.
Oh, yes.
And he handled the outhouses. And then back years ago, they had the old streetcars down there at Monaghan. You could come around by Monaghan. It would go around the belt. We called it the belt line. And you could get on that streetcar for a nickel, and you could ride all the way around Greenville on that streetcar for a nickel. And then sometimes at night, we would run down there and pull them wires loose from up overhead, and the conductor would have to get out of there and put it back on. Just little things like that. We was mischievous and all. But we had a good time. We had, like Gladys said, we had some good ball players. Us boys would go down and play ball, and when we'd knock a ball over there in 1 yard, they wouldn't let us get that ball. And that's Ms. Busby, Mr. and Ms. Busby, Senior. And there's just a lot of things that we did back then, and playing golf up there. Us caddies, we would, during the summer days, we would get out there and swing the swing blades for the butterweeds, cutting them down, and then a worthy boy would bring a push mower. We didn't have no gasoline mower, it was a push mower. He would cut our fairways. So we come up the hard way, but we had a great time in doing it.
Him talking about the money, we had a little office. And on Wednesday, if your food had give out, you could go there and get these coins, and you could take them and get the money. That was
the groceries, yes.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And we had anything anybody needed, so we didn't need to go anywhere. We was happy. And as we look back on it, we should have been happier than what we were. But it was a wonderful place then. And there's still some good people that live around here that was raised at Monaghan Mill. Yeah.
The activities of Monaghan really and truly centered around the Y. We had a good school, and we had good teachers, and we had what they called a May Day, and they had what they called the Maypole. And the girls, and Fanny was part of that. They would have a pole with ribbons on them, and they would go around and do some kind of formations, but it wouldn't twist the ribbons the way they, and all of that was activities. And as they said, the Y was the real center of Monaghan, because there we had our community Dr. White. And as she said, over on the left was his office and examining rooms and all. And then over on the right was a room that was for social events such as showers or conference and all, with a kitchen to it. Then downstairs, before we had bathrooms put in the houses, they had four stalls for the ladies for showers. And I don't know about the men. I never did go down in theirs. And We just, us children, we just thought that was the greatest treat in the world, was to go down there and get our hair washed in that warm water, showering. And for a nickel, you could get a washcloth, towel, and a little bar of soap. But you had to go back and give them back the towels and rags up there at the office. But I'm like them. I was proud of the teams that we had, and especially the basketball. I can remember some of them. Buck Waldrop, that lived on Beatty Street.